يوم الدنيا ولا اللهم إنا نسألك ونعوذ بك من سيدنا مولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم الحمد لله الحمد لله يا رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وعباد الرحمن الذين يمشون على الأرض هونا وعباد الرحمن الذين يمشون على الأرض هونا وإذا خاطبهم الجاهلون قالوا سلاما والذين يبيتون لربهم سجدا وقياما والذين يقولون ربنا اصرف عنا عذاب جهنم إن عذابها كان غراما إنها ساءت مستقرا ومقاما والذين إذا أنفقوا لم يسرفوا ولم يقتروا وكان بين ذلك قواما آمنت بالله صدق الله العظيم اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه السلام علينا وعلى عباد الله الصالحين أما بعد அல்லாஹ் சுப்ஹானஹு வ தஆலா வ அஸ்ஸ வஜல் மென்ஷன்ட் ஹிஸ் ஃபேவர் அண்ட் ஹிஸ் நியம் அண்ட் பிளெஸ்ஸிங்ஸ் அப்பன் தி And mention ya ayyuhanna su'budu rabbakum alladhi khalaqakum walladhina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqun alladhi ja'ala lakum al-ardha firashan was-samaa'a bina'an wa anzala minas samaa'i ma'a fa-akhraja bihi min ath-thamarati rizqan lakum fala taj'alu lillahi andadan wa antum ta'lamun اللہ پاک نے قرآن مجید میں اپنے کلام شریف میں انسان کو اس کی اپنی پہچان
اور اپنی اہمیت جاننے کا سماں مہیا کیا. سو اللہ سبحانہ و تعالی ان دا قرآن had mentioned to the human beings to appreciate who they are themselves, because we are not appreciating and not realizing that how a great honor and prestige and opportunity is given to us. Yes, in this world we recognize very much, if anyone wins £1 million, they think this is very great opportunity and a blessing which has come. A person who gets the job of his choice, he appreciates or she appreciates. A person who is married to who they want, for them it's a great thing. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wa azza wa jal is mentioning to realize our real essence and potential. Imagine you are here now on the face of the earth. The opportunity, the chance which you have, this chance and this opportunity, and which Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned to take advantage of, imagine it cannot be given to you again. Why I am saying this is that in order to give you what you already have, how you are living now on the face of the earth, Allah Jalla Majduhu ne insaan ko jo uski apni qadar aur pehchan karane ka aur usko khud janne ka, apni pehchan khud pehchanne ka jo hukm irshad farmaya, اس میں یہ ہے کہ اس کو جو موقع ملا ہوا ہے وہ اتنا زبردست ہے کہ وہ یہ خود بھی سمجھ سوچ نہیں سکتا اگر بہت گہرائی سے غور نہ کرے. Imagine for yourself کہ the opportunity which you have is for you to be in this 1435 or 2014, to you to be here and live as you are doing now. For that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the light and the noor of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now that's happened once, it's not going to happen again. And then if you would have given this opportunity again, how can you be given when such heavens, the seven heavens, jo saat asman hain, yani aapko jo mauka mila hua hai wo itna bada hai ki uske liye pehle to ek noor e muhammadi sallallahu alaihi wasallam Allah ne takhleeq farmaya, arsh kursi, Saat Asman, the seven heavens, the seven skies. And then Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam, phir Adam alayhi salam, phir kitne farishte Allah jalla majduhu created, the angels, kitne farishte paida farmaye. Phir sadiyan guzar gayin, mausam badalte rahe, the weathers were changing, the years were passing. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created this earth for you. Ye zameen Allah paak ne banayi. Is pe suraj, chaand, sari cheeze. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminding Allazi ja'ala lakum al-arda firashan was-sama'a bina'a. What we are being invitation is given, that just ponder that you do not know how lucky you are, how fortunate you are, wherever you are and the things which are around you, to recreate them, it can never be repeated, although Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can repeat whatever He wants. But to do this seven heavens and Hazrat Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam, and so many centuries are passing, so many messengers passed, and now this face of the earth and the other outward blessings and the people you live with, all these things should be there, and then you are placed on the face of the earth. Partly all of what's going around you, it is for you. وَالَّذِي سَخَّرَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي السَّمَوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا. Everything is working in your benefit. The sun, the moon, the stars, har cheez ek aapko dobara zindagi dene ke liye hoga nahi ki is tarah ki duniya ka mauka mile. Kahan phir ye hazaron saal pehle jo duniya shuru hui hai, shuru hogi, phir jo hai asman banenge, phir zameen banegi, phir jo hai Hazrat Adam alaihi salam aaye, phir kitne anbiya alaihi salam hote ab mauka aaya ke Allah ne aapko jo hai zameen par rakh diya, paida kar diya. To iske liye to piche bahut badi kainat Allah pak ne paida ki. Allah has created so many things. That is why one of the mashayikh, he said that in order to bring one piece of bread or rice in front of you, ek chane ka ya chawal ka dana, gandam ka dana jo aapke samne, aapko nahi pata iske liye kya chahiye, what you need for it. Iske liye ek asman chahiye, to recreate that one morsel of bread which is made of wheat or rice. Wo ek dana banane ke liye asman chahiye. There is a heaven needed, sky needed, clouds needed, a sun needed, an earth needed, the weathers are needed to just to bring that one piece of rice into existence. But it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who is doing it. Dekha hame to isliye ka bhi niche bhi agar gira ho, chawal, roti ka tukda, a piece of bread, pick it up, it is sunnah. ये रोटी का टुकड़ा है तो कई हम खा जाते हैं. We eat, why picking up this small piece of bread or chapati or whatever? But we are only seeing superficially. This is when we won't have it, because to make that available for you, that one piece of bread or few pieces of rice, there is a sun which is required for that. Where will you create the sun from? There is a sky, there is earth, and certain properties and qualities in the earth, and then certain weathers and water and canal and all other things. Then it comes into existence. And if that is taken away, all humanity gets together, they can't recreate. So that is why Rasulullah ﷺ advised that if something falls, don't look at it that its value is not valueless, because to recreate that or to make that available, you need all these things, heavens and earth and the weathers and the sun and the moon and the stars and everything, and then it comes into existence. Ask those people who do not get, like there is currently famine in an area in Pakistan where people are dying from hunger and thirst. They've never drank water which you drink, clean water. They've never eaten the food like the rice which you eat here in their lifetime maybe. animals, children. Anyway, what I was pointing at, that it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wa azza wa jal who gave you such a big opportunity to avail this opportunity. Is moke se fayda utha ke ye sabse bada business, the greatest transaction and business is which one do with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, hal adullukum ala tijaratin, shall I not inform you of a business? Because the greatest business is, and the transaction is, that you get saved from eternal punishment and enter the blissful life forever. That is the greatest transaction. Other is that you buy something, you get temporarily. You have business, you get temporarily benefit, profit. It's going to wither away. You must have heard about that Malaysian plane. Look, the weakness of humanity. Let aside saving people, that we, the humanity, we think we are at the peak of technological advancement in history, and saying we can know where a fly is, what's fly doing there, what's in the moon, etc., etc. Let aside fly or bird, such a thing like a plane has vanished, and after maybe weeks we are finding it, or months we are finding it. Where? And what finding it? Not saving, but actually now, that is also a success, to find the rubble, to the remnants of the people, actually, in spite of all this. All the superpowers of the world got together and they couldn't actually locate it. As it's not gone immediately in the ocean, but obviously it took time. But imagine that the helplessness, that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not guide, when He does not want something to happen, all technology, all superpower, this is not one person, one country, Asia, Europe, America, China, Australia, which are advanced actually, but now who could help those people? They passed away, and so many. So this is the, you may say, real power of human being, that if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not will it, a person is helpless. And when he has health, he thinks he is very, very big and very, very strong. You are only strong until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes you strong. It's like this light will only give light until the electricity is coming. I press the switch. If I turn the switch off, the bulb, the light, the microphone has no power to bring that power. Similarly, whoever has any kind of ability, any kind of power, beauty, money, a thing, it is until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills. Otherwise, this will never come to an end. When you see a person in government who is a king like Pharaoh or others in our times, as you think that actually they will never, actually there'll be a downfall of these people. But so many civilizations have come. There were Roman Empire, there were Islamic Empire, there was British Empire, and it looked that as though it's never actually going to have a downfall there, but look, where are they now? They say few people try to conquer the world and they could not do 1/4 of it. Alexander the Great, not even 1/4 they could have. Hitler and Napoleon, they had this idea, we are going to conquer the world. 1/4 bhi nahi kar sake wo with all that power, rather caused much disruption and much innocent people killing on the face of the earth. And there is Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who ruled 2/3 of the world. But his destination, his objective was not to conquer the world, was to just to benefit the humanity and give justice and rights to all the humanity, be it the worldly rights or be it the other worldly rights. Because in his time, America was not discovered. Australia was not discovered as such. So the world was starting from Europe to China maybe. And you can look at the Islamic kingdom, it's all almost two-thirds. Varun's maqsad bhi nahi tha. His purpose was not. His purpose was akhirah, pleasure of Allah, and actually giving people. Because he said, like we claim now, that any person does not sleep hungry in a welfare state. But many people do. They don't have shelter. They don't have. And it's only one country, let's say one Europe is one, they have different countries in Europe. And Sayyidina Umar bin Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu ruled in two-thirds of the world, and he said that even if a dog dies with hunger, I am responsible. So as I was mentioning to you the last Monday as well, that in Islam, compassion upon creation does not start with human beings or Muslims. Because our Lord is Rabbul Alameen and our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is Rahmatul Lil Alameen. He is Lord of all the worlds and everything. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a mercy for all the worlds and everything. So the compassion or the concept of rights and wrongs and the haquq of the creation does not start with, like Sayyid Umar bin Khattab is here mentioning, animal. But as I mentioned to you, that for a Muslim, even the earth, the verse of the Quran I mentioned, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, why? That my servants are Ibadur Rahman. You see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't say Ibadullah, although they're servants of Allah. But wherever He introduced His awliya, Allah Paak ne jahan apne nek bandu ka jo taaraf karaya hai, wahan apne sifte Rahman se taaraf karaya hai. Farmaya wa Ibadur Rahman. The servant of the merciful, all merciful are. So giving indication that like Allah is Rahman, His servants, they also reflect mercy. Like His beloved Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the greatest mercy, and he was Rahmatul Lil Alamin. So he manifests the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started with Alladheena, who are they? Yamshuna ala al-ardi hawna, that they are, my servants are such merciful, they are the servant of merciful, and they are such kind that they even walk on the earth humbly. They even do not actually harm the earth, meaning they walk also humbly on the face of the earth as well, because they also consider the earth as well. As I said, that these things in Islam, we consider them that they are alive as well. The stones, the earth, they witness. Like when a person says azan, these things are going to actually give witness for the muazzin wherever his voice reaches. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا. That when Yawma idin tuhaddithu akhbaraha, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, this earth is going to tell you all the news. These stones and trees and mountains, that they are what a person have been doing. So starting from the stones and the earth and water to the plants, plant kingdom, mercy and rahmah for the plant kingdom. If you remember last time I mentioned, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that do not cut down trees. Trees, they have life, they have feelings. They cry and weep. They become happy. The plants, they have. Then it extends to the, obviously, the human beings, and then to the Muslims, and then obviously to the angels and everything, all of the creation is included there. So I mentioned last time to yourselves that between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the servant, there are certain obstacles, certain things can become barriers. And if you know how to deal with them, then these things does not become barriers, but they even push you towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's closeness. They even, you can actually become more closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what are they? One is your own self. The nafs is a barrier itself. If you know how to control it, it takes you so higher. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى. It can take you very high. The nafs can take you. If it is, you know how to deal with it. Second barrier is shaitan. Shaitan is enemy, but you can use it as a step stone to come even closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if you know how to deal with it. Because the more he invites towards evil, and if you do not accept his invitation, you get more and more high towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The third barrier is dunya. You can use the dunya to become very, very high ranking wali. How only Allah do use dunya. Dunya, they get service from dunya. But if you do not know, then this becomes a barrier. Then you are entangled there. And fourthly, it is the creation, the people. Fifthly, blessings, ni'mas, blessings, be having abundance, money, health, knowledge, life, family. These blessings become a barrier as well. A person becomes entangled in there and forgets the one who bestowed these blessings. Lost in the blessing and forgot the blesser. Lost in the blessing and forgot the blesser, the who blessed. Sixthly, it is the afflictions, musibats, problems. تو یہ کچھ کچھ چیزیں ہیں اس میں سے جو بندے اور رب کے درمیان رکاوٹ بن جاتی ہے. اس میں پہلی چیز تو نفس بندے کا. اگر پتا ہو اس کے ساتھ کیسے, تو یہ آپ کو اللہ کا قرب دے گا. اگر نہ پتا ہو تو یہ جہنم کی طرف لے جائے گا. دوسرا شیطان ہے. اگر پتا ہو تو شیطان سے مقابلے میں بندے کا درجہ بڑھتا ہے اور زیادہ. اگر نہیں پتا کیسے کرنا ہے تو وہ پھر شیطان خود بھی بن جائے گا. دنیا یہ بھی بیریئر ہے. پتا ہو تو وہ مال چیزیں خرچ کر کے اللہ پاک کا قرب حاصل کر سکتا ہے. کام کر کے, محنت مزدوری, تجارت کر کے بڑا قرب حاصل کر سکتا ہے. نہیں تو وہ اپنا اسی میں لگ جائے, دھوکے بازی میں تباہ ہو جائے گا. تو دنیا بھی ایک بیریئر ہے, اور لوگ, بندے, مخلوق, یہ بھی بہت بڑا بیریئر. اگر تو اچھے اخلاق چیزیں کا پیدا کر کے بندہ بہت اونچا مقام لے سکتا ہے, اللہ کے ہاں اللہ پاک کو بہت پسند ہے وہ بندہ. الخلق عیال اللہ, حضور علیہ السلام فرمایا کہ مخلوق اللہ کا کنبہ ہے. The creation are the dependents of Allah, and Allah loves him most whoever is more beneficial to them. اسی طرح نعمتیں, یہ بھی بیریئر بن جاتی ہیں. جب نعمت ہے, مال کی, دولت کی, بچے ہیں, خاوند ہے, بیوی ہے, نعمتیں, نعمت دینے والے کو بھول کے نعمت میں گم ہو جاتا ہے بندہ. اور اگر وہ نہ, تو پھر وہ نعمت بھی اس کو اللہ کے قریب لے جاتی ہے. اور چھٹی چیز, مصیبتیں, پریشانیاں. اگر بندے کو پتہ نہیں کہ مصیبت پریشانی آئے تو کیا کرنا ہے, تو پھر تو وہ اللہ سے دور لے جائے گی. اگر پتہ ہو تو مصیبت بھی, اللہ نے فرمایا اذا اصابتم مصیبہ, اگر جن کو, مومنوں کو مصیبت پہنچتی ہے तो वो उनको पता होता है हमने क्या करना है. उलाइका अलैहिम सलावातुम मिन रब्बिहिम व रहमा, उन पर अल्लाह की रहमतें और यानी बरकतें और सलावात और उतरती हैं, उनको और अल्लाह का कुर्ब मिलता है. सो इट इज़ ऑल अ मैटर ऑफ नोइंग एंड प्रैक्टिसिंग हाउ टू डील विद इट. ये कैसे इसके साथ मामला करना है ये पता, बस इसी का नाम तज़किया है. तज़किया प्यूरिफिकेशन इसी को कहते हैं कि पासिंग दीज सिक्स बैरियर्स इन सच अ वे दैट दे डोंट बिकम अ बैरियर फॉर यू बट रादर दे बिकम एक्चुअली अ कैटलिस्ट इवन फॉर फर्दर क्लोजनेस टू अल्लाह सुबहानहु व तआला. तो पिछली दफ़ा हमने एक के बारे में बात कर रहे थे, वी वर डिस्कसिंग वन ऑफ इट, डीलिंग विद द मखलूक, डीलिंग विद द क्रिएशन. तो मैंने अर्ज़ की थी कि अल्लाह जल्ल मजदहू ने अपने कुर्ब के लिए मखलूक को हिजाब बनाया. अल्लाह सुबहानहु व तआला मेड द क्रिएशन एज अ वेल फॉर टू हिज क्लोजनेस. दैट हाउ एवर यू डील विद द क्रिएशन यू आर रियली डीलिंग विद अल्लाह सुबहानहु व तआला. तो बहुत सारे बंदे इसी में उलझ के रह गए. हम में से बहुत सारे बंदे, दूसरे भी बैरियर है, देर आर अदर्स एज वेल फाइव, बट दिस वन इज एक्चुअली ऑल्सो वन ऑफ इट. एंड मैनी ऑफ अस वी हैव बीन एनगल्फ्ड एंड एंटेंगल्ड इन देयर बिकॉज ऑफ द यू मे से बैड रिलेशनशिप, नॉट नोइंग हाउ टू डील विद द क्रिएशन. And it's not easy. Everyone tries to be good, to be nice, etc., etc. But it is what to do. What did Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam actually advise? What was his advice for actually the having to deal with the creation? Because everyone complained, I am bad to such a person because he has turned evil. He has been dishonest to me. She has actually been unfaithful to me. She has done that, etc., etc. Mothers, fathers, brothers and sisters, they have complaints against each other, the children, the husband and wife matter, the brothers and sisters, the neighbors, the relatives, distant relatives, general people. They can entangle you. They can entangle you. And then business partners, work colleagues, obviously whoever you are going to deal with, you are going to somewhat actually suffer or benefit, make them benefit or make them suffer because who you are dealing with. To uska solution to lamba hai, the meaning if we do a very detailed discussion on it, but briefly the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam mentioned various things. Few things I will share with you. It is like a medicine. If you use it, the creation will not become a barrier. Like I mentioned to you the story of Imam Zain al-Abidin radiallahu anhu, who was born in this month of Jamad al-Ula, and this month is attributed to him. His faiz, his barakah is in this month. Imam Ali bin Hussein, the son of Imam Hussein, Ali bin Zain al-Abidin. I mentioned to you that how much he and his father suffered. No one can suffer what they suffered in Karbala. And what he suffered before, and then what he suffered, the disgrace and mistreatment after as well. Imam Hussein radiallahu ta'ala matter finished when he was martyred. But Imam Zain al-Abidin, he carried on suffering for decades or so. He lived in time of Yazid and many Bani Umayya Khulafa after more than a decade. He, radiallahu anhu, one thing he did was that actually many after the martyrdom of Imam Hussein, when he came to Medina, there were many well-wishers around the Islamic world who made political parties and political initiatives and rebelliousness toward the very harsh and oppressive regime of Yazid and Bani Umayyah. And they asked, most of them, many of them asked Imam Zain al-Abidin that you are Imam, you are leader, we have this political party. Just move a little bit forward. There's not any place now in the back. So here is after the martyrdom of Imam Hussain radiallahu anhu, Imam Zain al-Abidin comes and lives in Madinatul Munawwara. And many political groups, they came out and they even asked Imam Zain al-Abidin to lead them, be a political leader to take revenge of the Karbala and to also establish the kingdom. But he said, I'm not going to participate in any of the political activity, because I have seen what people did to my father, Imam Hussain. He wasn't eager to go to Kufa. It was people who brought him into the political arena and invited him and then abandoned him. So Imam Ali Zain al-Abidin, who was a great wali and imam of his time, and so much so that he was by unseen, he was given a divine title of Zain al-Abidin, like actually he is the crown and ornament of the worshippers. Crown of the worshippers, he was. He spent his life in zikr, doing tazkiya and teaching people, and actually in worship. So he had suffered the bad treatment from people at the very extreme, which we cannot imagine. We have small complaints against people, etc., etc. So if you and your relationship with the people, the neighbors and others, spouses, brothers and sisters and aunts and uncles and others and general people is going deteriorating, is cold completely, is not actually good, you may say. So obviously the Prophet Ali Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam had his enemies, many of his family members, like Abu Lahab and his wife and others, they were enemies. Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam had his own uncles and actually family became enemy. So these people also suffered. So what was the formula? What was the formula they were using? That it didn't become, they didn't become a barrier or obstacle in gaining the closeness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but rather these people achieved high and high status. Usme ek baat to ye jo Imam Ali Zain al-Abidin radiyallahu ta'ala anhu ne bhi farmayi, pehle to unhone isse wazeh kar diya that the creation, aapne farmaya ki jo makhlooq hai iski misal bichhu ki hai. Pehle to ye banda samajh le. Zyada masla hamare logon ko isliye banta hai, wo samajhte hain ye makhlooq to hame fayda degi aur hame jo hai ye phool nachhawar karegi aur hum moj mela karenge, ye to hame bahut hi aaram sukoon pahunchayenge, inki nature ye hai ki hame fayda, hamari friendship, they will work in our benefit, they will actually be with us and they will benefit all the time to us. No one is going to be unfaithful, no one is going to con us, etc., etc. They have this view of the creation. Miyan biwi hai, shadi ho gayi, wo samajh, aap miyan samajhte, aap biwi mujhe hi serve karegi, ab usne aur kya karna hai.
बीवी समझती है अब हामिद है वो सब कुछ छोड़ के वो मेरा ही हो गया, अब उसने और किसी के साथ क्या लेना देना माँ बाप के साथ, अब तो वो मेरी माँ. First thing Imam Ali Zainul Abidin said that you have, well, what his teaching is, that wrong view of the creation. Ke makhlooq ka jo aapka view hai, wo durust nahi. Aapne farmaya makhlooq bichhu ki tarah hai. The creation nature is like scorpion. They will, at their own time, at their own choosing, they will sting, they will harm, they will bite, they will release their poison. Ke inke sath jitna bhi acha kar lo wo phir bhi aapko shar pahunchane se baaz nahi aayenge. How much ever good you be, they still going to harm you in some way. When you know this already, then it's not a news for you that someone has conned you. Then it's not a surprise for you someone has actually become unfaithful. Because you know this is the nature of the ye makhlooq ne to ye karna ye hi iski nature hai ye karte hi karti hai. Because actually if you want to see the nature of the creation, agar makhlooq ka aapne dekhna hai, अपना ही देखना, आप भी मखलूक में शामिल हैं, इंक्लूड योर सेल्फ इन देयर. इफ़ यू वांट टू सी द नेचर, द लार्जेस्ट एंड द ग्रेटेस्ट फेवर डन, इफ आई हैव बोट समवन अ कार और सम लेंट सम मनी टू समवन और डन अ फेवर, दिस इज स्मॉल थिंग. द ग्रेटेस्ट फेवर समवन हैज डन ऑन द अस इज पीपल इज टू क्रिएट देम from dust to actually such a wonderful thing, which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The creation and ourselves, meaning majority of us, we are not thankful to and sincere with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not faithful to Him. Then how much fool will that person be who thinks that yes, people are not faithful to Allah, they are not sincere, and they are going to be sincere with me. Who are you? You are nothing compared to the Creator as such, the favors which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has done. So look what they are doing to Allah. Allah is calling them to the mosque. They are not going to the mosque, to the azan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, do this, they are not doing. Allah is saying, don't do this, they are doing. So pehle to aap ye samjhe na ki aap मैं क्या खूबी है कि आपके साथ लॉयल होंगे, अल्लाह के साथ भी लॉयल नहीं है तो आपके साथ लॉयल्टी कैसी होगी उनकी. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल हैव दिस व्यू ऑफ द क्रिएशन दो कि भाई लॉयल्टी डोंट एक्सपेक्ट. ये भी एक इलाज है उन पांच चीज़ों में से, जो छह चीज़ों में से जो हुजूर अलैहिस्सलाम ने तालीम फरमाई, इमाम अली ज़ैनुल आबिदीन और सैयद अब्दुल क़ादिर जिलानी सब एक ही बात कर रहे हैं कि यही इनका इनकी फितरत है कि ये आपको दुख तकलीफ और डंग मारेंगे. दे आर गोइंग टू एक्चुअली हार्म यू. माँ अबू हनीफा रहमतुल्लाह अलैहि आल्सो सेड दिस. तो पहले तो ये व्यू रखें, इट्स नॉट यू मे से शुडंट बी अ सरप्राइज. दूसरा इलाज जो आपने, जो इमाम अली ज़ैनुल आबिदीन ने फरमाया और उससे पहले रसूल अल्लाह सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम ने फरमाया, कि वो ये कहते हैं कि हमने तो एक ही निचोड़ निकाला है पूरे वाक़े करबला और सारी बात का, वो ये कि दुनियावी मालो दौलत, इज़्ज़त मर्तबा, इल्म, जो कुछ भी हो तुम्हारे पास, वो जब मखलूक तुम उससे कम्पीट ना करो मखलूक के साथ उसमें, और अगर वो कम्पीट करें तुम कहो तुम जीत गए, उनको कहो तुम जीत गए. अगर तुमने दीन ईमान इस तरह आपका महफूज रह सकता है, इफ़ यू डोंट वांट टू कीप योर ईमान एंड माल सालिहा इंटैक्ट, ऑब्वियसली देन इट्स अ फेलियर एनीवे. बट ही सेइंग दैट real wealth which the shaitan and the dunya and the creation is after is your iman and your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These other things, worldly matters, land, property, money, political office, and all these things are just used so that they can entangle you, and you also use then those tricks and those tactics which they use, which are wrong ones, and you become entangled and you lose Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's relationship, and they have lost already, so you are in the same boat, and this is success in the eyes of shaitan. تو یہ جو رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم دوسری نصیحت جو فرمائی حدیث شریف میں بھی جب کسی صحابی نے پوچھا یا رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کوئی ایسی چیز بتائیں کہ لوگ اللہ پاک اور لوگ ہم سے محبت کریں that اللہ سبحانہ تعالیٰ and the people, the creation love us. The Prophet علیہ السلام said ازہد فی الدنیا اپنے دل کو دنیا کی محبت سے خالی کر لو detach your heart from the love of دنیا Allah will love you يحبك الله وازهد في ما أيد الناس and do not compete with people in worldly matters and detach yourself from that competition. I want to have a good car, I want to show the person I have the best car, I have the best clothes, I am strong, I have more money, I have more bigger house, I have best clothes. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam saying the deal with the creation, bahut sare jhagde to logon ke rishtedaron aur dusron ke sirf isliye hain ki wo in cheezon mein compete kar rahe hain. Wo kehte hain sharika baradri hai. اب دیکھیں وہ اس لیے وہ ایک عالم کہہ رہے تھے بھئی شریک برادری کا تو مطلب یہ تھا کہ آپ کے غم میں خوشی میں بھئی یہ شریک ہوں اور اب وہ ہے وہ سمجھے بھئی یہ دشمن ہیں بھئی وہ مذاق اڑائیں گے وہ کیا کہیں گے جو ہے ادھر بھی وہ the real situation was the relative should be relatively more helpful to the person لیکن آپ کہتے ہیں وہ شریک اور لوگ ہم نے شادی نہ کی شریک کیا کہیں شریک اس مراد وہ اپنے رشتے دار مطلب یہ تھا بھئی ان کی اصل تے شریک کا لفظ ہے کہ ان کے that their partner in their happiness in their loss in their profit everywhere that they are they will share the difficulty that's the meaning of شریک not that actually that they're competitors as such but now People have become like this. Now they are competitors. No one, to a neighbors, they are not competitors, but he is competing with his own cousins, own family. He's going, I should have this. Oh, I should have this. To ek to dusra, ek to maine ilaaj pehle bayan kiya, the first thing I said, that don't have wrong expectation from the creation. If you have this very fairy tale view of marriage and relatives and others and everything, Obviously, you will be depressed. Oh, ye kya ho gaya? You can expect anything from them. اور دوسرا جو فرما رہے ہیں رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم اور امام علی زین العابدین رضی اللہ عنہ اس کی تشریف فرما رہے ہیں he is commenting on that وَزْهَدْ فِي مَعَيْدِ النَّاسِ يُحِبُّكَ النَّاسِ If you will stop competing with people in what they are like and what they have money, whatever They will love you. They will love you. They are like animals. If you, until you have the corpse, meat, dead meat, which looks attractive to the wolves and dogs and lions, until you have that in your hand, they are going to roar and bark and harm you as well. They are going to come after because you have something which they like. If you throw it away, If you throw it away, I'm not interested in this meat and this all this. They will get on with their own. They won't bother you. But rather, they will. What will happen? That dog which you throw meat at him, the dog starts loving you. Doesn't that happen? جب آپ نے پہلے تو وہ کتا درندہ شیر آپ کے پیچھے بھاگ رہا ہے لیکن اگر جب آپ کہتے ہیں یہ لو کھاؤ اس جانور کو بھی آپ سے محبت ہو جاتی ہے تو ایسے ہی لوگوں کی مثال ہے پیپل آر لائک دیٹ ایز ویل پہلے تو وہ آپ سے لڑ رہے ہیں دے آر فائٹنگ یو اینڈ دیٹ بٹ وانس یو اسٹاپ کمپیٹنگ اینڈ سیئنگ نو دس از یہ لو یہ لو وہی لوگ حضور علیہ الصلوۃ والسلام فرمائے یو ہیب کناس دیٹ پیپل ول اسٹارٹ لونگ یو دیٹ از ون آف دا ریزن یہ ایک وجہ ہے کہ جو اولیاء اللہ سے لوگ محبت کرتے ہیں اسے اس سے محبت تو کرتے ہیں وہ اللہ کے دوست ہیں لیکن بہت سارے اور بھی نیک لوگ ہیں ان کے رشتہ دار بھی ہیں لیکن ان سے وہ نہیں کرتے دا پرائمری ریزن پیپل لو اولیاء اللہ دیٹ دے آر ناٹ کمپیٹیٹرز ان دا ورلڈلی میٹرز ان کو لباس کا کوئی نہیں کہ ہمارے ستارے لگے ہوں ہمارا لباس چمک رہا ہو ہمارے پاس گاڑی چمک رہی ہو تو جب یہ چیزیں وہ لوگوں کے لیے چھوڑ دیتے ہیں دیٹ دے ایکچولی لیو اٹ ٹو پیپل دے آر ناٹ انٹرسٹڈ ان ویری all of these things and not compete basically in them if someone does dispute they give it to them then people start loving from a heart them as well then again they get more then people with love give them again firstly they are competing with you they hate they are jealousy because you are competing with them Once you detach yourself from the competition, you come out of the race, you are sitting on side, they themselves bring gifts, here you are, here is this. Phir wo khud leke aate cheez. But now your share is coming to you, but with honor and love. Not, you are not attaining it with jealousy and competition and putting others down. It's coming. You see, this is deep wisdom. You need to think over it. It's not easy to grasp because that's why most people actually, they don't do and they actually lose on this arena, or on this front actually, relationship. With Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dealing with him. So, two things I have told you, that the treatment is the treatment. One is, don't keep the treatment from the creation. کہ وہ آپ کو نقصان نہیں دے گی وہ دے گی rather when you have this view that loss harm people can become unfaithful etc when they are good to you you have a surprise یہ آپ کے لیے یہ بہت اچھا ہے آپ کو اور خوش ہو جاتے ہیں کہ میں تو نہیں توقع رکھتا لیکن یہ بہت اچھا معاملہ کر رہے جو تھوڑی نیکی بھی کر دے It's like a person who have 100 pounds and you expect him to give you 100 and he gives you 90, you are still angry with him. تو نے مجھے 10 کیوں نہیں دیا 100 کیوں نہیں دیا How why have you not given me 100? But if you don't expect anything, any money from that person and he has 100 pounds and he gives you 10 even, you are more than happy, alhamdulillah, yeah. تو اولیاء اللہ سبحانہ و تعالیٰ لائک امام علی زین العابدین رضی اللہ تعالیٰ مینشننگ دے ہیو دس ویو آف دی کریشن وہ کہتے ہیں مخلوق اللہ کا ایک کنبہ ہے ان کی اصلاح نہیں ہوئی یہ نقصان پہنچاتے رہتے ہیں کرتے ہیں لیکن یہ جو تھوڑا بھی دے دیں تو یہ بہت بڑی چیز ہے تو وہ خوش ہوتے ہیں اینڈ وی ایز اے فیملی ممبر فادر اینڈ مدر دے آر ناٹ ہیپی ود دا چلڈرن وہ نہیں دے آر ناٹ گیونگ اس دے آر ناٹ کمنگ ٹو وزٹ اس دے آر ناٹ گیونگ اس منی they are not listening to us as such and such the children they are saying what has my father done what has my mother done they've not built property for us etc brothers and sisters they are because they expect 100% from each other and how can they give 100% when you and me are not 100% we are not giving 100% to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala we are asked to give 2.5% وہ بھی مشکل سے رو دو کے دیتے 100% تو ایک طرف رہ گیا زکوٰۃ 2.5 بھی نہیں ہوتی بلکہ وہ سیونگ پہ 2.5 ہوتی ہے سو اٹس ایون لیس دین دیٹ ریلی وہ بھی رو دے اور 5% اینڈ 5% دے تو بہت بڑی بات ہے اینڈ وین یو آر ٹو کریٹر یو شوڈ بی ہیپی ٹو گیو ہم آل بیکاز اٹ از ہز ہی ہیز گیون یو
when you are not giving and you expect 100% from people, that they give you 100% loyalty, 100% dedication, 100% honor, it will not happen. What's going to happen is that you will become depressed and you will also enter their race and jealousy, and you may say blame game will start and allegations, and finally you will end up alone. Like Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala said, that whoever expects perfection from friendship and people, he will end up being alone. Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala farmaya ke jo banda aisa dost dhoondta hai be'aib ho, aisi dosti, aise rishtedar, aise log jo be'aib ho, wo sirf akela reh jayega duniya mein. He will become alone. So if you are finding a flawless person, a friend, a family member, even a wife or a husband, you will end up being a bachelor or divorced or actually phir yahi hoga ki yahan is duniya mein sab mein thoda bahut aib kami beshi hoti hai. Ye anbiya alaihim assalam hain jo aib se paak hai, makhlooq to unse khush nahi hui. The prophets and the messengers, alayhim salam, they were flawless people. They were perfect people. They were masoom, and the people were not even happy with them. How can they be happy with us, or how can we expect them to be happy with us? तो ये तो पहली तो ये दो चीजें ज़हन में रखें कि एक तो अपने the view, the expectation, the nature of the creation, that scorpion example which Imam Ali Zain al-Abidin radiallahu anhu gave. Second is that do not compete. Unke saath competition mein na pad jao, kisi cheez mein bhi. Humne, mera rishtedar ne shaadi ki, hum usse badi shaadi karenge. Unke paas ye gaadi hai, hum usse badi gaadi lenge. हमारे उनके पास ये कपड़े, हम उससे ज़्यादा कीमती कपड़े लेंगे. फॉर वीमेन आई हैव दिस सूट, मॉडर्न सूट, अप टू डेट एंड द करंट वन. इफ़ यू आर कम्पीटिंग इन दैट, एंड यू आर इन कम्पिटिशन. एंड इफ यू अदर आर ऑल आर वेयरिंग मॉडर्न एंड अप टू डेट एंड द करंट फॉर एग्जाम्पल क्लॉथ, एंड द अदर गर्ल और अदर सिस्टर और लेडी इज वेयरिंग द सिंपल, उसकी मोहब्बत पैदा हो जाएगी दूसरी औरतों में. इसी तरह जो है जाहिरी खूबसूरती है, अब जितना मेकअप में कंपटीशन करो उसमें, दैट एक्चुअली दे आर नॉट गोइंग टू बी अ लव क्रिएटर बिटवीन, बट दे आर गोइंग ट्राइंग टू आउट डू अदर्स. एंड जो नहीं कर सिंपल, बीइंग सिंपल रियलिस्टिक, वो सारे उससे मोहब्बत, उससे जो है कदर होगी. दूसरे जो है आउट डू करते करते, एक दूसरे से अच्छा मेकअप करते करते खुद क्या पता कार्टून बन जाए, एंड टू आउट डू अदर्स. मतलब देयर इज लिमिट टू एवरीथिंग, एवरीथिंग इज मॉडरेशन, लुक्स गुड. तो वो एक दूसरे के साथ कंपटीशन करते करते अपनी शक्ल बिगाड़ ली, एंड यू कैन नॉट इमेजिन व्हाट लेंथ्स पीपल गो टू compete with people. They're always thinking in night time, in the home, I am going to, how can I come closer? You're not in competition with. तो ये दो चीज़ें हैं. है तो ये छः चीज़ें जो हुज़ूर अलैहिस्सलाम सलाम की तालीमात से हैं. आज तीन ताते हैं, तीन फिर इंशाल्लाह आपको बताएंगे. The third thing which Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said is, फरमाया के everyone, ये मैं कह रहा हूँ, कंप्लेन्स, माय रिलेशंस, माय दिस, माय दैट फ्रेंड एसेट्रा एसेट्रा, वी हैव फॉलन आउट. द प्रॉफेट अलैहिस्सलातु वस्सलाम सेड, सिल मन कतअक. अक़बा बिन आमिर रज़ियल्लाहु अन्हु नरेट्स दैट आई आस्क्ड एडवाइस इन दिस मैटर फ्रॉम प्रॉफेट अलैहिस्सलातु वस्सलाम रिगार्डिंग पीपल, नसीहा, एंड ही सेड टू मी, सिल मन कतअक, कि जो तुमसे तोड़ ले उसके साथ जोड़ो. दिस इज मेडिसिन, ये इलाज है. दिस इज अ कैप्सूल.
that whoever cuts ties with you, you enjoin ties. You join the bond. Whoever breaks the bond, you join the bond with him. Now, why we find difficult? ये मुश्किल किस लिए लगता है? Because we do it for ourselves or for the other person. Once you have in mind that you are doing it for Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala, then it's not difficult. Because you are going to, people think, what will happen to me? Where will I get? Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam mentioned another Sahabi, Imam Bukhari Rahmatullah Alayhi, in his book Adab Al-Mufrad, he mentioned that one Sahabi radiallahu anhu, he came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ek Sahabi aaye Hazur Pak sallallahu alaihi wasallam ki khidmat mein. Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, mere rishtedar jo hain wo Madina Sharif mein ya jahan bhi rehte hain, main unke liye bahut acche soch rakhta hoon, acche talqaat rakhta hoon. Wo mujhse talqaat kaatte hain. लेकिन मैं फिर भी उनके साथ उनका सलाम दुआ उनकी बेहतरी चाहता हूं. They actually try to harm me, they actually cut ties with me, but I try to enjoin ties with them. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned to him that if you are doing what you are saying, then Allah is going to protect you from all their plans and harms and their bad wishes, and will reward you from himself and bless you from himself. You don't need to worry that they are not reciprocating. Is it better that your cousin, your friend, returns goodness, what when he will give you £1,000? Or what he will give you a gift? Or is it better that Allah responds and blesses you in return? Aap dekhe na, there are two persons. One is your relative. You want them to return goodness. What will they are creation? They are only going to give you a gift now and then. One is Allah Subhanahu. What can He give you? Or what can He not give you? And in what measure He can give you? There is no comparison. तो हम समझते हैं अभी हम सलाम करेंगे तो हमारी तो इज्जत ही खत्म हो जाएगी. हम तो झुक जाएंगे. If that person is cutting ties, he is not saying salam to us, we are not going to say salam. तो लेकिन जो सलाम नहीं कह रहा आप उसको सलाम करें. आपको फिक्र है कि मेरी इस बेइज्जती हो जाएगी. तो ये फरमाया जा रहा है कि इज्जत अल्लाह के पास है. अल्लाह अपने पास से तुम्हें और इज्जत अता करेगा. उसने अगर इज्जत देने भी है तो वो उसके पास है ही नहीं, वो क्या देगा आपको. सो ये भी इलाज है. ये इलाज देखें, इलाज तो फिर जैसे पिछली दफ़ा मैंने किया, कई दफ़ा ऑपरेशन कराना पड़ता है, कई दफ़ा जो है सर्जरी करानी पड़े. समटाइम यू हैव टू हैव सर्जरी फॉर एक्चुअली गेटिंग क्योर ऑफ एन इलनेस. समटाइम यू हैव टू टेक बिटर सोर मेडिसिन. तो ये भी है, मुश्किल है, लेकिन अगर आप करेंगे तो देखें उसका इफेक्ट क्या होता है. कि जो बंदा आपको नाराज है, सलाम नहीं करता, आप उसको सलाम करें. जो आपकी दावत पर नहीं आता, आप उसकी दावत पर जाएं. जो आपकी दावत नहीं करता, आप उसकी दावत करें. जो आपको फ़ोन नहीं करता, आप उसका हाल चाल पूछें. जो आपके तल्लक वो तोड़ना चाहता है, वो रिसिप्रिकेट नहीं करता, आप जो है इनिशिएटिव लें. यू एक्चुअली टेक इनिशिएटिव. यानी जो तल्लक बोल नहीं रहा, आप उसके साथ बोलें. जो आप मिसाल के तौर पर ये जितनी मिसाल भी आप ले लें, तो इसका ये इलाज जो नबी अलैहिस्सलाम ने चंद चीज़ों में जो बयान फरमाई, उनमें से एक ये भी है कि जो ताल्लक आपसे तोड़े उससे आप जोड़ो. हमारा यही होता है कि मैं इसलिए नाराज़ हुआ है जी, अगला बंदा ही वो जवाब ही नहीं देता, वो ताल्लक ही वो ठीक नहीं, वो हमारे साथ रखना ही नहीं चाहता रिश्ता. ही डजंट वांट टू कीप एनी रिलेशनशिप विद मी. ही वांट भाई, यही तो नबी सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम फरमा रहे हैं कि वो जो नहीं रखना चाहता, तुम्हें रखना चाहिए. यू शुड बी वांटिंग रिलेशनशिप. हमारे लोगों ने नाराज़ के छोटी छोटी बातों, यही इमाम अली ज़ैनुल आबिदीन रदी अल्लाह ताला अन्हु की मिसाल मैंने आपको दी थी. दैट अ पर्सन हु कट्स ऑफ द हेड ऑफ हिज फादर, एंड हिज फादर वाज सच अ फादर दैट इज नो अदर फादर लाइक हिम एट दैट टाइम, इमाम हुसैन रदी अल्लाह अन्हु. एंड व्हेन दैट पर्सन कम्स, नो वन गिव्स हिम रेफ्यूज इन मदीना, नो वन एंटरटेन्स हिम एज अ गेस्ट. इमाम ज़ैनुल आबिदीन hosts him, serves him food and with bedding. And after 2-3 days, he goes and he says that it seems you have not recognized me. I am the killer of your father. Imam Zain al-Abidin said, yes, I know. When you entered, first glance when I saw you in Karbala, how can I forget you? I knew you were killer of my father. He said, then this treatment, this well-treatment, this all these good meals and good food and this smiling and these prayers and this etiquette and those best of the manners and talking with me, entertaining me, that. He said, yes, both things are there. But what you did was your way and this is our way. तो आप भी कहे ना सिर्फ सुभान अल्लाह ना कहें आज जाके अपना रास्ता ये बनाए दूसरा ये दूसरा ये करता है दूसरा ये करता उसको छोड़े व्हाट ही एवर ही डज आप अपना रास्ता बनाए दैट माय वे इज दिस ओनली गुडनेस विल एमिनेट फ्रॉम मी तुम नहीं सलाम करते लेकिन हमारा तरीका है सलाम करना तुम तोहफा नहीं हमारा तरीका है तोहफा देना तुम हमारे घर नहीं आते हमारा तरीका है तुम्हारे घर आना तुम हमें शादी पे नहीं बुलाया हमारा तरीका हम तुम्हें बुलाएंगे तुम ये नहीं कर हम जो तो ये आप अपना तरीके पे जाने वो उसका तरीका रहने दे उस तक लेट हिज वे बी विद हिम ही माइट चेंज एज वेल बट यू अडॉप्ट योर वे यू अडॉप्ट योर वे मैम इसी तरह एक हसन बिन नुमेरा गालिबन ये बंदा था जिसने मक्का पर हमला किया इमाम हुसैन मदीना पर हमला और इस तरह की चीज़ें He was the one of the governors in the army of Yazid and Bani Umayyah. When Yazid died, the other caliph became against him. He was in Mecca as a commander, but other armies came against him, the government. No one was entertaining because he lost the loyalty and the backing of the government. No one was feeding him. He came to Medina. No one was giving him, because then he is the filthy person, he did this, he actually invaded Kaaba. But Imam Zain al-Abidin gave him refuge and food from his house. Unko phir bhi aapne diya. Wohi jo banda aapko mahroom kar raha. To ye hastiyan, these people were not actually sent just as to be on the earth and go away. They were sent to be guides to solve our problems which we are facing. So ye teen cheeze aaj maine aapke samne bayan ki. Number one, I said don't expect goodness from creation, 100% goodness and loyalty and thankfulness. When they are not 100% loyal and thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, their creator, how can they be with you? They can't. Don't expect. And think that, as Imam Zain al-Abidin said, they are like scorpions. Scorpion meaning that if it is not stinging you good and well, you will be happy. Wouldn't you be surprised? यहाँ जो एक बिच्छू चल रहा हो इस सारे इधर अगर वो डंग नहीं मारा तो फिर मुझे हैरान क्यों होना चाहिए यार बिच्छू चल रहा है कुछ कर नहीं रहा दिस इज स्ट्रेंज इट्स नॉट स्ट्रेंज कि भाई इट हैज स्टंग तो मखलूक तो अगर आपको कुछ फायदा दे रही है इट इज गिविंग यू सम बेनिफिट सम वन इज बींग गुड विद यू यू शुड बी सरप्राइज ओ व्हाट्स हैपनिंग How is he? He said, Salam to me. What a wonderful thing. He gave gift, etc. Jo bhi aap so kare, wo surprise hona chahiye that this is against their nature. Lekin jab wo aapko takleef pahunchaye, samajh jao ye unka yahi tarika hai. First thing is that when you will have this view, and then little bit of goodness will come from your husband, from wife, from relatives, you will be happy and inshallah you will be able to reciprocate them because you will be thinking that they are doing more than actually they should be doing good. Second thing, don't compete with people, with relatives, with even husband. Sometimes people are competing with Imam Zain al-Abidin. He has said that don't even compete in knowledge, worldly knowledge as such, meaning one person says, I am right. Others say, I am right. I am right. So this is a clash of opinions. This is again egoistic game. कि मैं सच्चा हूँ किसी ने कहा मैं सच्चा हूँ वो दूसरा कह रहा है मैं सच्चा हूँ ये भी अपीनियन बस कंपीट ना करो भाई ऐसी बात कहो तुम ही सच्चे हो जो है अपने बस ठीक है जो भी है अगर तो कोई दीनी मसला है उसके भी अदाब है लेकिन दुनियावी मामले में बहस माम सिमिलर सेम पर्सन Hazrat the Imam Hussain radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, narrated from Sayyidina Ali karramallahu wajhul kareem, that he said that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all his lifetime, he never argued and entered a debate in worldly matter, and actually never lied. His tongue was free from arguments. He would advise people, he would answer people, he would actually answer questions, he would advise them, but argument mein to deeni mamle mein bhi nahi kiya, to dunyavi mamle mein to bilkul matlab uska nuksan hi nuksan hai. Especially our relationships in the houses and in families and relatives and others are mostly based upon these things. Actually kabhi wo maal mein hai, kabhi wo baat mein hai, kabhi is cheezon mein. So do not compete. Get yourself out of this race of competing with them in dunya, and get in the race and compete with shaitan and nafs. Unke saath compete karo agar karna hai. Don't compete with people and relatives and human. Unke saath race na lagao. Agar race lagani hi hai, mukabla karna hi hai, to shaitan aur nafs ke saath compete karo. Tumhe fayda hoga uska. Aur logon ke saath jo compete karne mein wo nuksan hoga. So ye chand cheeze hain, aur yahi tariqa-e Muhammadiya, in the tariq of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, tariqa-e Muhammadiya mein yahi siklaya jata hai. Why you are purified, your tongues are purified first, so that they don't harm others. Ears, hands, feet, and then actually positively then you are trained in there how you can be more compassionate, and then even with the mind, thinking for the benefit, humbleness, levels of humbleness, they are all geared towards actually creating such a personality. A person who've done the course of Tariqa Muhammadiyah, whatever his relation with Allah is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows, and he knows. But one thing should be observable, everyone can do, that this person will have these three qualities in him. It's rather more than three which I have mentioned, but actually three especially, that he will not be a person, argumentative person, self-opinionated person. He will not actually be cutting ties with the people who are not getting on with well, but rather will be joining ties. And there's a certain other traits which are observable by anyone. So, ye cheez hai. Jazakumullah ahsan, jazakallahu pak hamein bhi iski samajh naseeb farmaye. Allahu akbar, astaghfirullah, alhamdulillah.